Right now, here's the fiddler's dram and whiskey before breakfast. I'm sticking to this flat pick here. Let's see. Tell you what, let's do that tune called Mr. Garfield's Been Shot Down while we're right there in the right capo position for it. Some folks have asked me where that I got this particular set of words and recitation or whatever. It's partly my own get up, and I got some of it from Bascom Lamar Lunsford's recordings. He's a gentleman who used to do the Asheville Folk Festival in Asheville, North Carolina for so many years, started the Folk and Dance Festival over there. An old gentleman, he was a country lawyer in Asheville. He played the banjo and he rode a mule around through the mountains collecting songs back in the early days there. He was very dogmatic about his beliefs in traditional music and in the mountain people. And he really collected a lot of wonderful things. He recorded over 300 pieces for the Library of Congress from memory when he was up in years in one recording session. And so I've borrowed on his version, and then I've added a little bit, and then I've borrowed a little bit on a version that I helped record one time with Johnny Cash. And so it's coming from everywhere. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot way down low. Something sort of like this.
Mr. Garfield's been shot down.
Where they had Mr. Garfield laid out. I decided I'd go there and see him. About the time I got there, the doctor come a-riding up. He throwed down his saddle packets and he run in the house. He took one look at Mr. Garfield. He said, Mr. Garfield, if you should die today, where do you think you'd spend eternity? Mr. Garfield, he looked up at him sad-like, and he gave him something like this. I'd make my home in hell, Lord, Lord, make my home in hell. Doctor said, well, now that won't never do. He said, we better send for the preacher. Quick. Well, they sent for the preacher, and the preacher come. He got down on his knees, and he prayed him a great long prayer, and he got back up. He said, now, Brother Garfield, if you should die tonight, where do you think you'd spend eternity? Mr. Garfield, he looked up at him, folks, with a smile on his face. And that's what he said. I'd make my home in heaven, Lord, Lord. Make my home in heaven. Well, friends, about that time, Miss Garfield, she come into the room. She said, Mr. Garfield.
James.
She called him James. Mr. Garfield, if the worst should come to the worst, and you should not get well, would you want me to marry again? Friends, he looked up at her real sad, like with tears in his eyes. And he gave her something like this. Don't you never let a chance go by, Lord, Lord. Never let a chance go by. Well, now, folks, there's an awful big crowd gathered up there around that house that day. After a while, some of them, they decided they'd fix dinner. And I decided I'd stay and eat with them. There's this town dude there, and ask him what he's going to have. He give him something sort of like this. Go pass round your ham and your eggs, Lord, Lord. Pass round
there's this old country feller there. They asked him what he'd have. He said, well, just give me something I'm used to. Then he reared back and he give him something, went sort of like this. Oh, bring on your bacon and your beans, Lord, Lord. Bring on your bacon and your beans.
It all sounds good to me.
You hungry?
Going over there to Gordon's and tear that suit up tonight, ain't you?
Might happen.
Well, folks, it is getting late. And I had to go on home. I didn't get back to town for a couple of days. I come back to town, the very first thing I seen was Mrs. Garfield. She was walking down the sidewalk and she had a bunch of roses in her hand. And I said, Miss Garfield, where are you going with those roses? And she gave me something like this. Gonna place them on my husband's grave, Lord, Lord. Place them on my husband's grave. I said, Miss Garfield, where'd you bury him at? She said, I buried him on that long flowery branch, Lord, Lord. Buried him on that long flowery branch.
It's pretty up there.
Well, now, folks, I commenced to walking on down the sidewalk. And the very next thing I seen was the sheriff. He walked right up to this fella. He stuck a .44 right up in his face, right up under his nose. He said, is your name Charles Gateau? The feller, he says, well, yes, sir. He says, sometimes I pass this for him. That old sheriff, he reared back and he gave him something sort of like this. You're the very man I want, Gateau, Gateau. Well, folks, they carried Charlie Gateau down to the jailhouse. They locked him up in the cell. After a while, I got in there to see him.
Well, that was good.
He didn't look like he's a feeling too good, though.
Imagine not.
I said, Charlie Gateau, boy, how you feeling? He looked up at me, folks, with tears running down his cheeks. This is what he said to me. I'll hang on the 10th of June, Lord, Lord. Hang on the 10th of June. Mr. Garfield's been shot down, shot down,
shot down.
Mr. Garfield's been shot down, Lord. Mr. Garfield's been shot down. Get a little more land here to work with. 10-acre field for me to try to play this thing. That's
Bill Monroe once said, you can't play fiddle with guitar fingers. I'd like to attempt one here. It does feel a little funny after all that guitar playing. It's called Bonaparte's Grand March, and then we'd try to play one called Old Grimes from Dr. Doctor down there in St. Joseph, Missouri. I'm having a little problem right now, mainly calling up the name. D.H. Morris, I believe. Used to have a little fiddle tune book there. And then we'll try to play one called The Star of Bethlehem. Let's ambitious. Let's try a little. Thank you. somebody want to hear, My Love's Like a Red, Red Rose. I think you should do that one.
Get into the key of C here.
Thank you.
Thank you, love. We're going to do one song here called 50 Miles Elbow Room. And while we're doing this one, we get our good buddy Larry to get geared up. And they'll bring him a chair at some point. Well, they got him a chair. All right. Okay. Reckon that'll be too close to the speaker. Might be that way. Right? Yeah. We're gonna do 50 miles elbow room, and then Larry'll join us. Kind of by eye as well as ear, don't we? take this opportunity to bring a gentleman out here we told you about that spent a couple of years on the old Bluebird bus with us there. He says it's like riding the old cultivator sometimes. And
the glory road.
The glory road, that's right. Larry rode the glory road with us. Come on out here, Larry Slade. Now, I could make a real obvious joke about your Mando there if I wanted to about that and stayed on the vine too long.
Please
don't. Don't do it. Okay. What do you officially call that instrument, Larry? I know you got your own way of looking at it there, probably.
Well, this is my Mando Ghetto. I hope you like it.
Mando Ghetto. Okay.
One of them.
Uh-oh. Let me see. I'm a little out of tune myself. Give me a G chord right with a capo on there where you're at for a second. Let me see where I'm at. Maybe you better take it off and let me tune with you a minute. These new wires are not new anymore.
Let's tune with the cellist and don't tune it on the mic, please.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's not what I can hear. But
hit it again.
Only a Gibson's good enough. What will you say if it's a Gibson, it'll have to do. I like that. Well, we'll get back up in the key of A. I'll tell you what, actually, let's stay in G. I'm arranging here. We did a fast one, let's do a slow one. And we'll make you move that capo up and down that neck all night. How about that one? Actually, she's really gonna little jump now. How about Billy Gray, which involves that you completely lay down the guitar.
I didn't want to play the guitar.
Larry once said that playing with me was you needed radar. So this is what he's talking about. Okay. This is a song that I wrote a long, long time back there, and it's become an Irish song, sort of. They've recorded it, several of the people in Ireland have. And so it's the first Irish cowboy ballad called Billy Gray. Billy Gray rode in the country back in '83. There he did meet young Sarah McCray. The wild rose of morning, the pale flower of dawning, the herald of springtime in his young life.
day. Sarah, she could not see the daylight of reality. In her young eyes, Billy bore not a flaw, knowing not her chosen one was a hired gun, wanted back in Kansas City by the law. Then one day a tall man came riding o'er the Badlands, flying to the north of New Mexico. He was over to say he was looking for Bill Gray, a ruthless man and a dangerous outlaw. Came creeping to Billy fast sleeping there in the Clarendon bar and hotel. He fled toward the old church on the outskirts, thinking he'd climb up to the old steeple bell. But a rifle ball came flying face down. He lay dying there in the dust of the road where he fell. Sarah, she ran to him, cursing the lawman, accepting no reason, knowing that he was killed. Sarah lives in that same old white frame house where she first met Billy some 40 years ago. And the wild rose of morning has faded with the dawning of every day of sorrow, those long years of song. And written dusty winds of long, long 18 words to a passing world say. True love knows no season, no rhyme, nor no reason, just as it's cold as the Granger County clay. Yes, true love knows no season, no rhyme, nor no reason, just as cold as the Granger County clay.
When I left, I know it made him sad. But now I'm going back to that little old log shack where I spend my happy days as a lad. In my dear old southern home, I was happy as I could be, where the mockingbirds sang and I was at rest in that little old log cabin by the sea. Make a thing, yo. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Goodbye, friends. I'm leaving today. Goodbye, friends, I'm going far away from my dear old southern home. Nevermore I will roam. I'm going right back there.
Howdy, folks, howdy. We're glad to be back one more time at Ellis Hall here in Springfield. Glad to see all of our friends. I heard him calling names out there. I know all them people. Glad to see them. Well, we've been out of riding the roads as usual. And it's getting a little busy out there. We'll see if we can. We might do all right tonight if we can think of what we're supposed to play. Here's one we'll try to do called the Old Tar Heel. Thank you. started off with one that I've sort of named the Old Tar Heel. I learned it off of some sheet music, and there wasn't. It just says Untitled, and it seemed like a nice tune. And I actually, this boy from over in North Carolina used to play with us. Carl Jones was playing it too. And so he, being from North Carolina, I thought Old Tar Heel kind of suited it. And then that last one we snuck off into was called Brickyard Joe's, the name of it. And I reckon we'll sing one for you now. We'll do one that's written by that great country and western songwriter, Lord Byron. So actually it's a collaboration between Lord Byron and John Duffy, I guess. Tom Gray, some of them guys in the country, gentlemen. Silence or tears. Something earlier about the gentleman on sound there from said he worked with the Ozark Mountain Daredevils at one point. You made a track on the record with them, didn't you?
Thanks to their good friend and roadie and maple burn there.
Mm-hmm. Maple, now, he's from up in St. Louis, ain't he? Originally, maybe.
No, I remember
seeing him. Kansas City. Kansas
yeah,
City.
I remember that's seeing him on okay. the street back when I was about 14. So.
Yeah,
he's been around a while.
He's quite an instrument collector, too. I don't know, last time we saw him, what was he doing? Was he working with Emmy Lou? Maybe he worked with her as a roadie. And he worked with us. Not the height of his career there. He works with us for fun, actually. He works with them other folks for money, and he works with us once in a while for fun.
I think he took a trip with us after he quit Steve Martin, was what it was.
Yeah, he went from Steve Martin to us. And so. Well, how about while we're geared up here on in the key of B flat, why don't we just go ahead and play that there old Garfield's Hornpipe and the old Mountain Ranger there. Thank you. you what. Let's do a tune here. We'll stay in the same key for a while. It's comfortable there. Let's do a you from Dixie. I guess this one was written, I forget the date, as they tell me, 1911 or something like that. In the Tin Pan Alley in New York City. Kind of got taken into the country music world. Something I'd like to say to you. Don't be surprised if you recognize I'm no detective, but I just surmise you're from the place I'm longing to be. Your smiling face, it seems to say to me, you're from my homeland, my sunny homeland. Tell me, can it be? You're from Dixie, I say from Dixie, where the fields of cotton beckon to me. I'm glad to see you. Tell me I'll be you and the friends I'm longing to see. Are you from Alabama, Tennessee, or Carolina? Any place below that Mason-Dixon line? Are you from Dixie? I say from Dixie, 'cause I'm from Dixie too. Way back in old late at night, when first I crossed that Mason-Dixon line. Gee, but I yearn, I long to return to that old place that I left behind. My home's way down in old Alabama, on a plantation not far from Birmingham. One thing's for certain, I'm surely flirting now with old southbound train that run to Dixie. I say to Dixie, where the field of cotton beckon to me, and glad to see you. Tell me I'll be you
Are you from Alabama, Tennessee, or Carolina? Any place below that Mason-Dixon line? Are you from Dixie? I said from Dixie, 'cause I'm from Dixie.
Get out this old fiddle tuned up in sawmill here. Nancy always liked to play this one here. She says, play that old tune called the Georgia Railroad. We probably played it last time we was down here. We don't know but two of them, and this is one of them. This is the other. Kind of like the one of our fan club meetings. One of the guys, we didn't have to cancel the last fan club meeting. One of the guys got sick, and the other one had to work. My goodness, that hurts in two places at once.
Oh,
right in the same key. I've been good for staying in the same key here this evening, haven't I? About old Mother Flanagan.
Last week for a
that was an arty gig,
and it was for for a collection of 19th century American oil landscapes. And, you know, it just really just put me in touch with the fact that we will forever be out of place in this particular century. It's no big deal. I just, you know, was a little heightened awareness of that. True story.
Well, that is true. That is true. About the key of open A there. Try that. A is in A. Let's do one called All the Good Times Are Over. See if I can remember it all.
You've been that friend to me.
All the good times are past and gone. All the good times are over. Yes, all the good times are past and gone. Like the blossoms on the clover.
About one more, and I think we'll probably take a little break. And I had some people come up and ask me up front, says, you got any tapes or anything? And yes, we did bring some tapes. We got, I don't know, you've probably seen them before. We got Blake and Rice number 2. That's on a CD and a cassette. We have that on both. And we have Blind Dog, which we did in 1989. It was nominated for the old traditional Grammy Award, and that is on CD, and that's on cassette tape also. And we have a couple of video things with us also this trip. We have a television show that was released in, I believe, it was originally done in 1980, a little time back, and it's an hour show, and it was done at the University of Ohio in Athens, Ohio, and it features the trio that we used to perform with, which was Nancy on cello and myself on guitar and James Bryan on the fiddle. Well, that gets the commercials out of the way. You're listening to 950 in the Bathtub of the South. Yeah, let's do that. We'll close off this set with that. We're going to get our good buddy up on the next set, I think. If he brought one instrument, I'm not sure what it was back there. Larry Sledge is around. And Larry had the extreme experience of working with us for a few years there. And went on to bigger and better things there. I always knew the boy would. But we always had a good time with Larry.
You'll see that I've got my mandolin in good shape now. You're welcome, too.
Now, I need to get this hillbilly crutch off if you're going to play the mandolin, don't I? Unless you're going to play that old Granite State or something. But, them in the swamps to get in, too.
I've got my...
Got your repertoire all...
Got my heart set on it.
Fixed up there. All right. Good. Thank you.
thank you, Nancy. Thank all of you. We'll see you in a few minutes. We have a gentleman to handle these records and tapes, and I'm not sure where that'll take place. I don't know if it'll be out here or outside somewhere, but he will be out there shortly, or wherever he is.